In today's world of sales, you really have your work cut out for you, navigating complex deals that no longer only include the director of IT or marketing manager. Now, you have an entire buying committee to win over. The missing piece to your woes are influence or account maps that allow you to effectively organize account information and find the best path to sale. Today, you'll learn how to get started with creating Lucidchart account maps from within Salesforce, and after watching this video, you will be able to create account maps directly from the information already available in your Salesforce account. First, search for an account in Salesforce. When you open any account, notice the Lucidchart account map button located here in the top right corner of the account feed. Click on it to open the account maps associated with this Salesforce record. If you don't see the button here, don't worry. It's just because the integration hasn't been installed yet. Just talk to your Salesforce administrator about installing the Lucidchart integration for Salesforce. Now, you can see we have a large account map already created for this account that includes containers and swim lanes to help divide up the different departments that may be involved with this sale. Anyone with access to this account in Salesforce will have the access to view, edit, and comment on this map. Another great feature of our Lucidchart Salesforce integration is that all the account maps are attached directly to the account, so critical information stays within the company, and reps can easily find it whenever territories are reassigned or new reps start working on an account. However, when you've opened a map for an account that doesn't already exist, you'll be taken to a blank document that looks more like this. Notice the toolbox here on the left-hand side of the screen. This toolbox includes all of the contacts attached to this Salesforce account. They're listed in alphabetical order, but you can use the search bar at the top to search for specific records if you like. When you're ready to build your account map, just click on the record you want to use, and then drag it out on the canvas and drop it wherever you like. Let's go ahead and grab a few other contacts so we can build out a simple account map. You can see the name and title of your contacts right on the shape. To get more information, you can click the Contact Details button in the bottom right corner of the shape. This will display more relevant details about this contact, such as their phone number or email address. You can even edit this information by clicking Contact Details. This will take you directly to the Salesforce record of that contact, so you can edit and update their information. Then, just click back into the Lucidchart tab and select Refresh here in the toolbox to have the new information pushed back into your account map. You can further customize a contact record using the special shape properties bar at the top of the page. See how I can include a photo, either by upload or by entering in the URL of an image. I'll just copy this image URL from LinkedIn so I know this contact's photo will always be up to date. I can also assign my contacts a role that automatically changes the formatting of the shape. These contact roles are mapped from Salesforce and completely customizable. Let's go ahead and assign all of these contacts a role. I can even connect a contact to their LinkedIn page by pasting the URL for that page here. Notice that now, this contact has a button linking directly to their profile located in the bottom right corner of the shape next to the Contact Details button. Using the Salesforce Account Map tool, in addition to Lucidchart's already robust feature set, you can create powerful and functional account maps that will help you clarify the actors involved with your sale, as well as reducing the time to close. And now, you can find your best path to sale using Lucidchart for Sales.